Hello and welcome to C++ Weekly. I'm your host, Jason Turner. I'm available for code reviews and on-site training. This episode, I'm going to cover C++ 23's new feature, which is ifConstEval, how that compares to isConstantEvaluated and ifConstExpr. Okay, so let's start with ifConstExpr. ifConstExpr, or known in the standard as constExpr if, was added in C++ 17. Now, this is a compile time check that must be provided with a constant expression. And if you're not familiar, constExpr is short for constant expression. It makes virtually no sense at all to have an ifConstExpr outside of a template. I'm demonstrating something that's not going to work to show the point of ifConstExpr here. Now, this is a regular if statement, and I am saying if the thing passed in is integral, then I want you to return 42, else I want you to return 4.2. Note I get this here, an inconsistent deduction for auto return type int and then double. This 42 is an int, 4.2 is a double. So I have two different code paths here determined based on the type of the thing passed in, and that changes the type of the thing that is returned. I can't do this with a regular if statement, but this is why ifConstExpr was created. This is a compile time switch requiring a constant expression here. Then it is choosing which one of these to compile. Now, keep in mind that they both must be syntactically correct. I can't do something like this. Here we go. Blazor was not declared in the scope. So even though this branch technically wasn't compiled, it was compiled, it just wasn't chosen in this particular template instantiation here. So I'm returning 42 plus 5, and I'm getting the return value 47 from main. And if I were to make this return 3.8 here, then I'm going to get the 4.2 overload because this is not integral. And then I get my W conversion error, which is exactly what we want and why we have so many warnings and errors enabled on our examples here. So now I get 8 is returned from main. Okay, so that is ifConstExpr. There is no short-circuiting in ifConstExpr. They have to be nested if you want to say if is integral and then if is whatever, that kind of thing. So that's ifConstExpr, and that's not really the point of this talk, but we need that for the background. So then in C++ 20, as people had been doing more and more compile time constExpr work, they realized that they needed some way of deciding at compile time what method to take to implement some feature, because you might have more dynamic memory available to you at runtime, or different resources, or you may be able to do compiler intrinsics or something like that. Now, it is important to point out, we're no longer talking about a metaprogramming templated kind of context anymore. So a library routine was actually added in C++ 20 called isConstantEvaluated. If we go back to this example, notice Error is constant evaluated, always returns false in a non-constexpr function. That's a tautological compare. Let's go ahead and make this a constexpr function. And indeed, this one above could be a constexpr function as well. So we're going to get this conversion from double to int changes value, blah, blah, blah. So if we were to go back to using auto return type deduction here, we're going to get that compile time error again, inconsistent deduction for auto return type of int and then double. So we're going to make this just return 43 instead of 42. So I'm calling this do work is constant evaluated. And I'm getting the value 43 returned because I did not evaluate this in a constexpr context. So we'll do a quick example. Now, this example is interesting because it actually brings up an interesting point about C++ and things that are known as core constant expressions. A core constant expression is any const integral value that is initialized with a constant expression. Do work is constant evaluated. This is in fact a constant expression. So I'm going to get 42 returned from main here with the value a because of this is constant evaluated. And if I return b, I am also going to get 42 returned from main. So I kind of accidentally made a terrible example, but I knew it was going to happen and I don't mind sharing it. If I remove the const here, this no longer becomes a core constant expression, and I am going to get 43 returned. See 43 here. So just to keep things interesting, there we go. So I'm returning A, and this is no longer constant evaluated because it is a double, not an int, even though this value is const. So, but that's fine. We're going to keep this version now. So if I've got this, and I'm saying this is not constant evaluated, so I'm not evaluating it at compile time. And it's going to end up being something more like it lets us choose at runtime. Let's keep in mind, this is a runtime check. It is technically a runtime check, but with a value that must be provided by the compiler here, this if is constant evaluated. Now let's go ahead and see what happens if we add constexpr here. We actually get an error from the compiler. Fortunately, when this feature was first released, we didn't get this. Is constant evaluated always evaluates to true in if constexpr. That's because we're saying, please, at compile time, ask me if I am being executed at compile time. So this is always going to be true. And if you have if constexpr, is constant evaluated, you're going to get this problem. We need to put this back to a double so that this is no longer getting in the way of our example. Actually, I'll just do this. Okay. So this is where C++23's if constival comes into play. And it's spelled like this. This is kind of weird. This is the only switching control flow construct that we have that doesn't have parentheses. This isn't switch or while or for or do. There's no thing here saying, you know, inside the parentheses evaluate this thing. So if this is constant evaluated, then return 42. Now see, we are getting 43 back as we expected. And if I switch this over to B, then we should expect to get 42. Good. We're getting 42. And it also has this interesting syntax where you can do if not constival, to get the same logic. So this, if const eval, is just a different way to spell if is constant evaluated. That's all it really is. It's there to prevent this confusing use of if constexpr is constant evaluated, which then probably also makes you ask the question of, did we deprecate is constant evaluated? And no, we did not deprecate is constant evaluated, because we might want to do other logic. We might want to do something like, if it is const evaluated and something else is true. And this might be a better way of expressing this. But for the most part, if you find yourself in a situation where you need is constant evaluated and you have C++ 23, then if const eval is going to get you there in a more succinct way. So one more new feature from C++ 23 being covered here on C++ Weekly. If you like the episode, you know what to do. Make sure you give a thumbs up and subscribe to this channel, of course, and check out my Patreon and my best practices book, which is always in the description of each episode.